Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study how to perform the subtraction of two hexadecimal numbers directly without converting to any another base. As we know, the base of this number system is 16. The valid digits for hexadecimal number systems are 0 to 15. In this, there are all digits from 0 to 9. After that, 10 is represented by A. 11 is represented by B, then 12, we use C, next is 13, that is D, we use E for representing 14, and then F for 15. So these are all valid digits in hexadecimal number system. In this problem, the digits given to us for subtraction is 5DC minus 3AF. We will write it here, 5DC3AF, we have to find the answer here, okay. So before performing this subtraction, we will replace this D and C by the exact digit values in hexadecimal. This 5D is 13, so we will write 13 here, C is 12, then 3 is 10 and F is 15, so we replace F by 15. We are going to perform the subtraction now directly without converting to any another base. What to do? 12 minus 15 is not possible here, so we need to take a borrow. Whenever we take a borrow in any number system, one borrow is equals to the base of that number system. So in this case, whenever we take a borrow in hexadecimal number system, one borrow is equals to 16, that is equivalence to 16. Add these two, 16 plus 12, it is 28 minus 15. If you perform 28 minus 15, the answer is 13, and 13 is a valid hexadecimal digit. Okay, so we have taken one borrow from here to here, so the remaining number is 12. 1, 2. 12 minus 10. 12 minus 10 is 2. 12 minus 10 is 2 because we are given a borrow here. So here remaining is 12. 12 minus 10 is 2. 5 minus 3 is 2. All are hexadecimal digits, valid hexadecimal digits. To represent this 13, we are going to use what? It is D. So we will write it. It has 2, 2, 13 is D. Your final answer is 2, 2, D. Therefore, 5DC base 16 minus 3AF base 16 is equals to 2, 2, D to the base 16. To understand this hexadecimal subtraction, direct subtraction, in a better way, we will see one more example. This is our example 2 in this video. We are going to solve BA, BA to the base 16 minus DA, D to the base 16. Again, we'll going to use that rule. So answer, in the answer we'll write it as it is, given numbers BA BA minus DA D here, and we'll write our final answer into this text. Now we'll have to replace this B D and A with the actual this numbers. What is B? B is 11 and A is 10. A is 10, right? So we'll replace it here. B is 11. A is 10 in hexadecimal. B is 11. A is 10. Minus D is 13. D is, you see, D is 13. So we replace here in our example D by 13. A is 10. Again, there is d. D is replaced by 13. Now the direct subtraction takes place. Here 10 minus 13 is not possible. So what we are going to do? We'll take a borrow. We'll take a borrow from this place. When you will take a borrow, one borrow is equals to 16 in this number system. 16 plus, if you perform this, 16 plus 10 is 26 minus 13. The answer is 13. 16 plus 10, 26. 26 minus 13 is 30. We have taken a borrow from this place. It means the number remained is 10. 10 minus 10 is 0. If you see here, 10 minus 13 is not possible. We need to take a borrow from this place. We need to take a borrow here. Again, that one borrow is equals to 16. 16 plus 10. 16 plus 10 is 26 minus 13. 26 minus 13 is 30. As we have taken a borrow from this place, one borrow from this place, remaining number is 10. 10 minus 0 here is 10 as it is. This is the answer. But we'll replace this 10 by the actual digits in hexadecimal, that is 10 is A, whereas 13 is D. So we'll do that. 10 is A, 13 is D, the 0 as it is 0, and this 13 is D. So this is the actual answer. So we'll write it here. A, D, 0, D is the answer. Therefore, we can say that BA to the base 16 minus BAD to the base 16 is equals to AD 0 D to the base 16. So this is our final answer for this subtraction.